Burlesque is a tasteful form of striptease. It's done in a very classy way. Because, you know, with the rockabilly scenes, it's all about nostalgia and, you know, punk rock's about, like, doing your own thing, right? So it kind of submerged and, you know, girls got together, started doing these shows and trying to recreate this old style of striptease.
Going to the root of the word, burl actually means to make fun of. So burlesquing something means making fun of something, and usually in a naughty way. What probably people think of today is the kind of 50s stripteasy golden era stuff. The old pinup pictures brought to life. Fan dancing, bumping and grinding, the shimmy. When you couldn't show it all, you know, way back then you'd have to, you know, do the very suggestive movements.
Started at sort of at the turn of the century. I'd say it would be pretty boring back then because, I mean, if you showed an ankle, that was really risque. So I think it peaked in the 30s and 40s when there was actual burlesque circuits around North America and people were able to tour huge theaters. It was known as the poor man's follies, when all the beautiful, talented girls went off to do the Ziegfeld follies on Broadway. All the not so good looking, not so talented girls who are just trying to make money because, you know, the war era and all and whatnot, they went into burlesque. But it became really popular because, you know, just regular people would go in and pay, like, you know, probably a dollar or whatever to see a show, and they would do little striptease, they'd have an orchestra, they'd have comedians. It was a full show. I think a lot of the burlesque shows that happen now are based more on the 50s era and 50s style of burlesque. Just rock and roll, like stand-up bass, baritone sax, you know, just guitar, like a little singer doing a little mashed potato or whatever. And then you have the girl come out in her glittery outfit and doing a little, you know, striptease and a lot of the tassel twirling, which was more common than it was in the past, because like I said, nudity was not acceptable in the 20s and 30s.
I believe there's more class in burlesque than there is in stripping. I would never do the full strip.
I always get complimented, like they say, oh wow, this is very classy, it's not like stripping, it's not raunchy, and you know, that's kind of what I'm going for, and I think that's what the appeal is.
Your typical variety burlesque show is strip teasers, comics, singers,
musicians,
specialty acts.
It involves a lot of nostalgia and the whole aesthetic of vintage style. I preferably like the 50s. There's more color and glitter, and I'm really big on costuming and makeup.
The difference between strippers and burlesque dancers is that strippers make money and burlesque dancers just spend all their money on costumes.
The costume I had was the poodle skirt. I'm not the glam, pretty, sparkle kind of girl. Instead of putting a poodle on it, I put a skull in all glitter and sequins, and it was awesome. I like to throw a little trash in there too. I originally was going to do something else, completely different than what I did, and it was more like a 1930s look, and I just kind of realized that it wasn't me. I can't put it together. I'm going to look like a complete idiot. I got to stick to what I know and who I am, and that's more of the 50s style. I was so nervous. Oh my goodness, I was so nervous. I was sitting in here and listening to my iPod, playing the song over and over and over again, and right before I got on stage, all the anxiety and the nervousness just kind of went away, and I heard the crowd cheering, and it gives you this huge rush. Holy cow, that's gonna be me. They're gonna be clapping for me. And I was really excited. I think it went horrible. I got so carried away. I was trying to do a song that had the least amount of music playing. That way I didn't have to be sitting there shaking my boobs to absolutely nothing. And the song was actually too short. I got on stage and I just gave her hell. And I got kind of carried away, and I saw my friend in the front row who was practicing with me the night before, and he kept pointing to my top, like, take it off, take it off. I'm like, oh, shit, the song's almost over. I whip off my top, and the song was done, but it worked. It was okay. Nobody noticed, I'm sure.
I'm not a professional dancer, and that's the beauty of burlesque, because I think burlesque is very forgiving. You know, there's just not a lot of judgment, and it's a great way to explore like other hidden talents you might have. It's not Broadway, it's burlesque, so you can kind of do whatever you want. And someone once said to me with burlesque, if it's good, it's great. If it's bad, it's still good. So that's kind of the motto.